In this video, we will be looking at the importance of notifications when monitoring IT environments, how to set up a good notification strategy, and I'll show you a few concrete examples of how to set notifications up. Let's get into it. Notifications are a part of our daily lives. Emails, text messages, reminders, push notifications. They can be a blessing and curse in equal measure. Many of these notifications can be extremely useful. They can help you stay informed on important topics and remind you of appointments, for example. Maybe you even got a notification when this video was published. If you didn't, hit subscribe and the bell icon now. Having said all of that, many notifications are not important. They're annoying and can usually be deleted upon receipt. The problem is that there's a risk that important and valuable notifications get lost in the noise. This means that you usually need to find a good middle ground of what notifications to receive and which to mute. And it's the same in IT. For notifications in IT environments, it's crucial to be informed about errors, problems, or failures quickly. After all, issues in IT not only lead to unhappy users, but can also mean financial implications for companies. Notifications about the current status of the infrastructure, devices, and more are vital to keeping everything running. But just like in our personal lives, it's easy for important notifications to be lost in the overall notification noise. When it comes to getting the most out of your monitoring notifications, there are several factors to consider. Firstly, which are the crucial notifications that require immediate attention? Which are the notifications that do not have to be resolved right away, but that are good to know? How do you receive the notifications, such as by email or SMS? And of course, who receives the notifications? It's exactly at this point that you might find yourself Googling how to manage IT notifications. And here we are. The ability to manage notifications in an IT environment hinges on three things: defining triggers for notifications, defining how the notification gets delivered, and defining exactly which users or teams get which notifications. Defining the trigger for notifications is the basis for your notification strategy. In some cases, you can get notifications before things get critical, such as when your email storage is approaching 90% of capacity. In other cases, you can only know once there has been a failure. Developing a good notification strategy requires that you analyze your environment and decide what you need to know when. Then you can go about defining the events that trigger those notifications. These triggers could be things like the change of a status, high data volumes, slow data traffic speed, and other things. Let's talk about a few common triggers. The change in state of a device or a connection is often a good indication of an error. For example, if a server changes from an online state to offline for a prolonged period of time, there's probably a problem. And this can be used to trigger a notification. Another good notification trigger is data or connection speed. If speeds drop very low, it could indicate bandwidth problems. Volume is another good one and is especially useful for storage. For example, you can select to be notified when storage volume reaches a certain percentage of the total storage capacity. Thresholds are also a good way to generate notifications. Once you know what the normal operation parameter for a device or connection is, you can set thresholds. If the value is exceeded, you get a notification. An example of this is monitoring temperature of a device. If it reaches a certain temperature, you get a notification. By selecting the correct triggers, you can ensure that you get notifications for any critical or important event in your infrastructure. Notifications can be delivered in many different ways, from email through to push notifications on a mobile app. It's all about finding the ideal way to get important information about your IT to the people who need to see it. And this depends a lot on the kind of events that trigger the notifications. For example, urgent triggers such as a server going down or a data center temperatures rising unexpectedly need to be acted upon immediately. And for these, you need to find immediate and direct means of notifying the teams responsible, such as SMS messages or app notifications. Even apps like Microsoft Teams or Slack can be utilized for this kind of urgent notification. Alternatively, warnings of potential issues, such as storage space running out, can be sent by email since urgent reaction is not required. The third cornerstone of a good IT notification strategy is making sure the right people see the notifications. IT departments can consist of several employees or teams that are specialists for one or more IT areas. Think of things like virtualization, cybersecurity, network, and so on. Each area could have a separate team looking after it. You might also have teams that take care of specific applications, such as databases, emails, or backups. The correct recipients must be defined for each notification, and it's a good idea to have an escalation process defined as well. Now, managing these three things can be done with your monitoring tool of choice. To demonstrate, we are going to show you an example using our own Paessler PRTG monitoring software. Let's say that we want to trigger a notification when the state of a specific device changes from up status to down. We then want to send the notification to specific teams using both Microsoft Teams, SMS, and let's say a push notification to a mobile app. Let's start by setting up the notification for Microsoft Teams. This is done in three steps. Create a connector, create a notification template in PRTG, and then create a trigger in PRTG. You first need to create an incoming webhook in Microsoft Teams. The webhook URL will be used later in the PRTG notification template. Navigate to the Microsoft Teams channel and click on the three dots and then choose connectors. Search for incoming webhook, and once you find it, click configure. Type the name of the incoming webhook and click create. If you want, you can also upload an image. Copy the URL from this screen and save it to the clipboard, and then select save. You will need this URL when you set up the notification template in PRTG later. You will now see a notification about the webhook creation in your Microsoft Teams channel. Step 2. Create a notification template. In this step, you create a notification template that will send notifications to Microsoft Teams. Open the PRTG web interface, then navigate to Setup, Account Settings, Notification Templates, Add Notification Template. Define the template name and other parameters here. For this example, I will keep the default settings. Scroll down and enable Send Microsoft Teams Message. Now you enter the URL of the incoming webhook connector that you set up in your Microsoft Teams channel and click Create. Step 3, create a trigger in PRTG. Now that we have a notification template, we need to set a trigger. Notification triggers define when PRTG will send a notification to an IT admin. You can define notification triggers on different levels in your device tree, from root, probe, group, device to sensor. PRTG supports various notification triggers. For more information on these, you can take a look at the PRTG documentation. In this case, I will use a state trigger. PRTG will trigger a Microsoft Teams notification if the sensor is in the down status for at least 30 seconds. And that's it. You will now receive customizable notifications via Microsoft Teams. Another popular and reliable notification type is via SMS. SMS is also a reliable alternative when there is a disruption of the internet connection. PRTG also offers SMS notifications, and we'll take a look at an example of how to set this up. To enable SMS notifications, you will need an SMS gateway. This can be realized by a physical hardware gateway or through an online service of your choice. Many of these providers also enable sending via REST API. Ultimately, the choice is in your hands. In this example, we assume you have your own hardware with SIM card. In this case, it is just a matter of integrating the SMS gateway into PRTG. The following steps are how you do this. Open the PRTG web interface, open Setup, System Administration, Notification Delivery in the main menu bar. For providers not listed in the configuration mode setting, select Enter a custom URL in the SMS delivery section. Enter the custom URL in the appropriate format for your gateway. If all data is correct and the test is successful, you can now use this notification type as usual when setting up notifications in PRTG. If your monitoring tool provides an app and push notifications as PRTG does, you can also use this option for notifications. You can install the PRTG app for iOS or Android from the respective stores on your smartphone at no additional cost. The big advantage of this is that, on the one hand, you can always keep track of all the information about your network and its devices, and on the other hand, you can still access it via a mobile data connection, even if you have internet problems. Almost everything is possible. You can acknowledge alarms, stop and restart sensors, set priorities and favorites, scan your network status instantly, work with the ticket system, and edit object comments. Push notifications give you control over what triggers a notification and how often PRTG apps should check for new alarms. And you can configure widget notifications and stay informed even if the PRTG app is not explicitly open. Of course, what you've seen in this video does not cover all the possible notification options. To find out more about the PRTG notification options, visit our website where you can find information about other possibilities like Slack, Event Log, MQTT published notifications, and more. Thanks for watching, and if you have any questions or suggestions for future topics, put them in the comments below.